My diligent girl, a poor approach to discipline can mortally wound your will. Ironically, the most progressive souls are the same ones that feel obligated to discipline themselves, but their initial attempts are usually so clumsy that they lead to frustration and discouragement. There is more to this than the obvious step of graduating your trials in the measure that your abilities develop. The error you will commit in the beginning will be to exceed your grasp, to underestimate the effect of time on the strength of your will. Then will come a second attempt and another failure. If you follow the pattern of most people, you will waste some time trying different methods until the lack of results ends up discouraging you. Experience the discouragement. Take a long break. What you need is time to change your approach, not your goals. First, review your motivations. If your goals are rooted in self-love and vanity, even at a sublime level, discipline will always have a bitter taste. The goal will be tainted by a false premise that goes against nature, the ego. If your goals are about you, then you can only count on yourself and not on the universe. However, this is the only type of goal that can be honestly pursued in one's youth. Feigning altruism will not make you love the world. Practice the love you are prepared to feel, and if at that moment it is self-love, travel that road and explore the consequences. When you are finally sick of loving yourself, do not fall into nihilism, much less self-loathing. Keep exploring. The answer is on the other side of your skin. You are the accomplice of a superior beauty that transcends your name and your lifespan. Contemplation and admiration for the architecture of nature will open your eyes to this awareness. Then you will no longer recite poems to impress others, but instead, because you will be genuinely and unselfishly impressed by them. This is where true discipline begins. Now you will feel the obligation to become one with all this ambition and beauty. You will want to be one more leaf on the tree, and this humble aspiration will require more work than all of your previous egotistical goals. But your load will feel light, because you will be flying on the wings of purposes that are greater and more eternal than you are. There are many false awakenings before this authentic awakening. One of the signs that we are finally aware is an indescribable sensation of wanting to be consumed by that which we love. We want it to eat us, use us, and melt us. When this happens, the ego is transformed into an instrument rather than an obstacle. Healthy discipline becomes a daily ritual in which we extend our abilities slightly beyond our comfort level, and then return to a resting position. There is no more overtraining, competitiveness, anxiety, or haste. It is like praying through our actions. It is like gracefully stretching ourselves each day in that direction and offering a small dose of constructive pain simply to make ourselves worthy of the characteristic we admire. So, we want to be strong because we admire strength. We want to be wise because we admire wisdom. We want to be beautiful because we admire beauty. But we do not worry about how others perceive us, because our ego is no longer the protagonist. We only want to lose ourselves in these principles. We want to be part of the substance itself. This is a quantum awakening, but our self-knowledge continues to grow gradually. Without self-knowledge, discipline is an aberrant form of autoflagellation that is even more pathetic than sloth. When you know yourself, you know how much you can give without breaking down. And you will provide better service than those who focus on the pain rather than the results of their efforts. Be like the gods you admire. Do not punish yourself for doing the right thing, but do not sleep in indulgence either. Find your ideal midpoint, that is, where your will is nearly consumed, yet your goals continue progressing.